I've asked around, and the word is that grime is not a dirty word. It's a genre of hip-hop music. One man who is documenting the up-and-coming stars of the grime scene is businessman Anton, aka cameraman Sketch, who joins me in the studio to give me a little bit of an insight. To me, Mr. Cameraman Sketch, grime music is like a form of hip-hop that came to light, but not to popularity amongst parents for its seemingly perpetual derogatory language and coarse lyrics. Is this why you wanted to get involved?
Well, grime, obviously grime's it's a big thing now. It's getting bigger and bigger, but it's like, it's what people have been through. Like, grime is what you do from day-to-day basis. It's just like your life. I don't know, like, the genre of it, obviously it's growing and growing, but it's just music at the end of the day, and everyone's just trying to progress their music, and everyone's got their genre. Because me, I'm just, obviously, I'm in the grime scene with filming, because I film, that's what I mostly film, but I do film anything. But the scene is like, it's a big scene, it's growing, but if everyone gets together and puts it in a nice way, it can grow more than more. It's just the word grime, it sounds what it sounds, but
yeah, it sounds dirty. Yeah.
You should come to one of the raves. It's totally harmless. It's,
yeah.
You know, nice vibes all night.
Ooh.
PAs. Mm-hmm. Artists go there.
So tell me then, how did you first become a filmmaker?
Okay, my first started being a cameraman is, funny enough, I'm going to tell you my secret. I went on holiday with a few friends, my friend Leon and another friend, and we had a camera. I started filming lots of things. And then when I got back to the UK, obviously I always go to London back and forth. I have friends that are artists. And then the artists, I just filmed them doing a couple of freestyles and I put them out there. And as soon as I put them out there, the response I got was so big, I just started putting them on YouTube, and then I started managing an artist called Desperado.
Right, okay then. So that's how it started, and you began to document grime music artists who were unknown.
Yeah, unknown, mainstream and unknown. I put like both of the genre together because in this scene, a lot of it gets separated. This is where I'm trying to bring it all together, where if you've got good music, I'm trying to get your good music out there. So I help artists that are underground, mainstream, in the middle, anyone. I'll help anyone.
And how long ago did you start to film?
I've been in the music industry for just coming up to 2 years now.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, then. So you describe yourself as a workaholic when I was chatting to you.
A workaholic.
How hard do you work? Just describe to me, because it sounds amazing.
Brief. I've got 440 videos on YouTube. I'm on my third DVD. DVD one was a one disc. DVD two was two discs. And I'm on my third one now. I'm halfway through it. And I do live performances filming that. I've done about 40 to 50 of them. I travel anywhere.
In Nottingham?
At UK.
Okay.
I'll travel anywhere.
So in terms of, it's 440 videos on YouTube.
Yeah.
So what, are they little 2 minute, you know, snippets or?
Up to 10 minutes. Whatever an artist can give me. If they can give me a mini video, a freestyle, an interview, I'll take anything. But I don't, like, just the music thing, that's what I'm like, I film most times. Sometimes I film the football match. I film certain things in my spare time. Even a christening, I'll do anything.
Isn't it?
I'm just trying to just be me as a cameraman.
So in terms of pushing yourself hard, you were telling me that, you know, sometimes it comes to the stage where you will literally just break down.
Yeah. A good, like, I get about 30 days. Last year I had 30 days of rest, but that was like just through breakdowns. Like, just, I've had a 1 week holiday, and then not 10 days I just won't be able to do no work. So I'll just be so stressed. I just have to sit down and chill out. Have to chill out. Because I'm always on the motorway. I know every junction 26 to number one there is.
Okay.
And beyond.
And what kind of places do people hold grime events? Because, you know, because I remember hearing places like Barnes for some like house type of raves back in the day and stuff like that. Is that the sort of thing that we're talking about? Or are we talking in people's houses or just in centre of towns?
Well, grime events are everywhere, mainly in London, but when... some in Leicester, there's some in Derby. I've been Sheffield at Niche, at Sheffield Super Duper in Leicester, and I've been multiple places. It's everywhere, but there's certain areas that actually do grime, and they don't get as much of it because they holler at me sometimes on Facebook, say, "Oh, I know Sketch, you come here and here. Could you come to us?" This is where I think I'm trying to broadcast it more, so obviously I can get here and there, because I will come to certain any area, as long as if you're trying to do the music and you're trying to push well.
So is it U1? Doing all of this filming?
It's just me one doing all the filming.
And in terms of the respect that you've got, how do you measure your success?
My success last year was quite high, so because everyone said I did quite a lot last year and they said I wouldn't be able to match up with it, but we're only in June, July, and I feel like everyone's saying, well, you're doing a lot again, Sketch, you're doing it again. Like, people ask me when my DVD's coming, and that was the one that's already out, and then people ask me when's the next one coming out next year, and it's coming out this year, because the DVD's called 2010.
What is the significance of these DVDs then?
My DVD is it's a collection of artists that this year is a collection of artists from like that are doing a lot of work. So there'll be OGs in there, there'll be Boy Better Know, and there's a lot of artists that are actually doing a lot right now, the hard work. And then I had a little competition where any artist can get on a DVD feature by just vocaling a track I gave out. And the winner was a Knots artist called Kills.
Okay.
So that's big up the Nottingham people.
Excellent.